Hi guys, this is your boy Alano B, the billionaire, big brand as always, and we are here to educate you. And then we have new merchandise, caps out. Thank you for those guys who have been supporting by buying. And you know what, when you have a vision and then you have people around you who can help you grow your vision or your goals, that's the best thing in life and the best thing in business, or the best thing with friends. So thank you guys for promoting the brand Alano B, the billionaire. And today I just want to talk about cybersecurity in Africa. You know, funny thing, as technology is still growing in Africa, and we are prone to things that we are not aware of. For example, if you look at our internet, we're still young. We're still pushing online stuff and we are still improving. But then we have a lot of things that happen online, in that if you are not steady, you can be affected. For example, when it comes to cybersecurity and malware and everything that involves protection of your data, your information online, especially from big companies, like big brands like banks, telecom companies, and any company that involves or do their business with a lot of technology, there are things that if you consider, you can protect your data or you can be a victim to it. There's a time I was checking with a friend online how many malware, how many viruses are sent across each continent, from US, Asia, Europe to Africa. And for example, in Africa, there's a country, I think it was Malawi or Zambia. That country is prone to attacks with cybersecurity, with viruses. I don't know why, but if you check, if, for example, right now, you don't consider investing in internet protection in your company, there are a lot of things that you might lose. People are attacking companies where you see, for example, there's a time Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, their accounts were hacked. Big brands, their accounts were hacked on Twitter, and the person who hacked was wanted Bitcoins. So if those kind of guys, their accounts can be hacked, and the guy is asking for like 1 billion Bitcoin, who are you in Africa with your internet security? Because antiviruses, they are not as protective as they are. So this interview I was watching from Patrick's channel, where he was interviewing this guy who was the founder of John David McAfee. He killed himself from the allegation where he was run away from US, and the US government was looking for him because of tax evasion. But now look, from his interview, he analyzes how many people are prone to cybersecurity. He says that there's no way you can protect your data as long as you have logged into your account online. So people who have done cybersecurity or who know how to hack, as long as you log in into your details online, anybody can be able to hack your account as long as he has the knowledge. So many companies in Africa, especially Africa, what I literally know is that they are not well protected online, and there's a higher probability of those companies losing very important information or data. There's no, in Africa, if you check online how many countries in Africa are attacked in comparison to UK, US, very few countries in Africa are attacked, because Africa, they believe they don't have what we call enough information, or people are broke. So this means even if I attack you and I'm requesting $1 million, you will not be able to pay me. But continents or countries like Dubai, US, UK, France, Italy, online you will see how much these guys are being attacked with cybersecurity. So with this information, what am I saying is that if we are into this, what we call development, Let's also focus on cybersecurity. This one will help us to protect our information online. And the guys who are doing IT in school, major in what will be the key focus in future. Very many companies will require those, hackers who will be able to protect their companies from this being a victim to this information. And if you don't do right now, or if you don't invest in cybersecurity at the moment, then be rest assured that in any time you will either be able to pay for that for not taking care of the company's crucial information, or you will have to let your data go. There's a company I was working before, and there's a time we received an email, and this email, it was sent to somebody's email address. When the guy opened the email, all our emails stopped working. How did we do it? We had to wait for the guy. The guy had to get some information from other people who are good with hacking, in that they had to help the company not to lose information. If it wasn't that kind of system, then that company will have lost the information, or will have paid heavy fine to the guy so that he can be able to clean the computers. And that's a small company. Just imagine banks, telecommunication companies. There's a lot of information that needs to be protected. So as you think of starting a company, doing business online, make sure that you invest in cybersecurity so that you don't be a victim to this kind of attacks. This is your boy, Alan Obi, the billionaire. So guys, don't forget to subscribe, share videos, like, dislike, and you can also do your order for the merchandise. We have capes, we have t-shirts, we have wristbands, and many more are coming. Hoodies will be there, and also long-sleeved t-shirts. Thank you guys. Peace. Alan Obi, the billionaire.